We've got Lazar Stefanovic and Will McClendon. We'll open it up for questions.
Guys, what does it feel like to lose a game like that? You know, you're up, get an emotional shot to take the lead with 6.6 left, set your defense, look like, you know, you get the stop, and then they get a put back at 2/10 of a second left. What's that like to go to bed?
It feels horrible. I don't know exactly how to explain it. It feels horrible. Had a game in our hand even before that. So it doesn't always, it came down to that last play, but you can count 20 plays down the stretch that we didn't make, we could have made, which made a difference. So it, you gotta learn from it, you gotta be better.
Yeah, Coach Cronin talked about a breakdown in defense. You know, what did you guys see, especially in that last minute? What broke down from your perspective?
We know he's really fast. We should have done a better job of staying in front of him. That's really what happened. I mean, things are going so fast. You know, you don't want to get a foul or anything. It's just how it played out. We should have just stayed in front of the ball, and hopefully the outcome would have changed.
Well, Coach was talking about, you know, saying that scouting report is a thing in this game, and he's saying that, you know, just like you were saying, staying in front of Smith makes a difference. How important do those small details that you may see, you know, that may be bullet point 3 or 4 when it comes to a game like this, to score a lost by 1 point?
I mean, they're huge. They're the answers to the test. I mean, have a scouting report like that, and the coaches do a great job of letting us know, preparing us. We got to meet them halfway, and we didn't do that to the best of our ability today.
Every possession matters, and every play matters. So didn't make enough of them today, and that's what happens.
Lazar, from your perspective, obviously losing Sebastian, you know, your leading scorer is obviously big. Did you sense the play getting chippy before that? And what did you think of just the physicality from that point on?
Did I sense what, sorry?
Did you sense that things were getting chippy before then? And what did you make of the physicality from that point on?
I mean, it was a physical game. It's two physical teams. And they beat us pretty badly the first time. So it's we came in. We knew we had to be tough. They out-rebounded us. That was the biggest reason we lost the first game. So it's, you know, what we had to do. And they're also physical teams. So it's nothing, I don't know, it's nothing crazy. You know, like nothing, it happens every game that teams are physical. And I don't know what happened with Sebastian. I didn't see exactly what happened. But it's that's what happens sometimes with physical teams.
Will, you talked about staying in front of the driver on the last play. What was kind of the talk in the hall of the do's and don'ts going into that last sequence?
Stay in front of the ball, stop the ball. It's really in rebound. We should have got the rebound as well. So Mona did a great job of forcing a tough shot. And usually when you're 5 men, stops the ball, it goes to block the shot, it leaves a mismatch for the guards and the bigs, and we didn't do our part and blocking out and getting the rebound.
Any more questions for the guys?
Lazar, how do you, you guys have USC coming up this week, how do you bounce back? And do you feel like you're a more mature team now than maybe when Utah beat you the last time?
We're definitely a more mature team. I don't know how. I mean, you just have to. So the season's not over. We know what the position we're in. When every game that's left, and go one by one. So it does hurt. As I said before, we got to learn from it, get better, understand why we lost, and get going from there and try to win next week.
Any more questions? Thanks, guys.